Switching what game? I just realized I didn't even check the aspect ratio on this.
Let me tell a tale,
no.
My child. Hush now.
No. Hold on. I have to do something. I'm sorry. Alright, we're just gonna fight with it. Hold on! Sorry! Let's go to that button. Play.
Let me tell it.
Sorry. Game. Catcher. Edit. We're doing it live. Thank you, Omni. New game hype indeed. Where's the edit button? There it is. No, we want that one. Let's see if this works. Probably not.
Tail, my child.
Aha, okay.
Hush now.
Oh, good grief. Come on. Really? Whatever. No, it's all messed up now. I can't even control Z it. No. I'm sorry, everybody. This is a weird aspect ratio. I may have to just, like, put this in the middle. This looks terrible! Games that don't let me adjust this! Why? Do we care if it's letterboxed? That looks really crappy. Oh! Edit. It's the wrong button. Is that locked? That's not locked. Okay. It's not what I wanted.
And listen well.
No! We may have to deal with it being letterboxed. It looks terrible, though. No, don't do that. Okay, at least it's on screen now. I'm gonna close it and start it up again, just for good measure. Let me reorganize things slightly. I apologize, but we're doing this live! I can see all the relevant information now. Alright. Play!
Let me tell a tale, my child. Hush now, and listen well. How a queen the Rom Lum scorned, on her daughter the price fell.
Oh, that sounds a little sad.
A beautiful girl, a princess most fair, and a kingdom lost for many a year.
Why are all the princesses always, like, blonde? These sorts of things.
Guests for her baptism were picked with care, lest the wicked fairy appear.
So this is a retelling of a tale from the Brothers Grimm.
She wanted revenge for such
or at least an altered by the Brothers Grimm tale.
With an ominous gift. She shan't live long, the hag cursed and broke loose. A spindle will prick her, in death she shall drift. From the fairies came prompt a spell to help out, but the evil was strong and too hard to undo. The worst was averted, but as fate played out, the girl fell asleep, and the kingdom did too. A kiss will save her, one of true love, but many have tried and met their demise. Of that prince, though, pure like a dove, some say he'll go far to prove otherwise.
Wait, is he proving to people that he's not as pure as a dove? I will edit it as soon as this is over. If I exit out, it'll, like, freak out for a second. Maybe I can change the settings now. Hold on. Options. Oh, really? That's all we get? I don't like it. What? English and Italian? That's it? Okay. That's fine. Alright. Let's fix the game volume. Alright, how is that? Is it too loud now, or is it okay? Thank you. Yes, it is a very lacking options menu. That means I probably need to turn down the booping, because that's... Wait, there's another one. Oh, for Pete's sake, no! Give me real settings! Why? I'm sorry, the game is letterboxed. Back to what it was? Okay. Doop-a-doop. That might be... Alright, is it still okay? Do I need to turn it down more? And I apologize for being so unprepared today. Heesh, that's loud in my ears. There. No, I don't want to report bug. No setting changes for resolution. Alright. Let's start. Select one of the empty files to start a new game. Select your previously selected file to continue the game. Finally, I have arrived to the outskirts of the Enchanted Forest. It has been a long journey, but this is the last obstacle I shall challenge. It is me, Prince Stephen the First. Steve! We're calling you Steve now. Who will save Princess Aurora, who according to the legend lies sleeping beyond this enchanted forest? And yet, the thorny briars, there's a typo, are way denser than I expected. Will my sword be enough to carve a passage through these brambles? Say the first language for it was Italian. Ooh, it just opened. Oh, but what happened? It almost seems like an invitation to enter deep into these thorns. What? A fairy? Welcome, O adventurer. I am the fairy who warns whoever dares to access the enchanted forest. What brings you here? I am here to rescue Princess Aurora and unchain her from her doom. Oh, I see. So there are still men gifted with bravery in this world. I wish you the best of luck. The journey will not be easy. You shall prepare yourself to face this adventure. The forest is enchanted and many have lost their way there in past times. Irritating the small folk will mark your end, so be kind and generous with them. I thank you for your advice. I shall be careful. Use the mouse to move around the environment. Open the inventory. To open the inventory, click on the bag icon and look over here. If you're stuck, you can receive a hint from the fairy. Don't forget to come back here and talk with the fairy. They are wise creatures that play tricks on you, and don't take gifts from them. You'll regret it, probably. Wise creatures, and she could have something useful to say. Good luck on your quest, Prince. No item. Resume. Solve this puzzle to receive a hint. Alright, what happens? Do this. Oh. I didn't need a hint, but... Seems like there's nothing... What did I do wrong?! Alright, let's go. Wait, can I get the rock? I want the rock. I have a glorious hat. That is about all I can tell you right now. It's a bird. Give me the hammer. Lo, the castle! Proceeding seems impossible. With these brambles, it will not be an easy feat. So use your feet. Just walk over them. If you have good footwear on, it should be fine, right? No! A huge mushroom to which some chandeliers and weird items have been attached. Is that all the... Okay. I can talk to the bird. It is just a bird roosting in its nest. It looks like someone has built a mailbox for it. I wonder why. Oh, it's not a hammer. Oh, I'm not doing that. Nope, I'm done. I tried. So, is that a thing? Oh, a briar rose is thriving among these brambles. I can't go that way. Down I go. Hello, gnome. Now look here, a village of enchanted creatures. They look like gnomes. I only heard about them in legends. I shall try and interact with them. I will talk to you. Oh, adventurer, welcome to the village. Wait, no. Oh, I can use my gnomish accent. Okay. Oh, comma, adventurer, exclamation point. Welcome to the gnome village, comma, home to great builders and artisans, ellipsis. Or so it should be, period. My subjects have recently had a quarrel, and now they can't accomplish anything no more, exclamation point. They have been working on an... No. Let me serve her. They have been working on the new library for days, comma, but now the works are in deadlock, ellipsis. As long as they fight, comma, the situation won't change, comma, I fear. Period. Ah, under this tree, some wild mushrooms have grown. Judging from their nibbled conditions, they are edible. Exception made for the red one. That one is still alive and well. Working in this village is impossible, exclamation point. They fill you with daft requests and just choke completely your genius, exclamation point. But I am done, exclamation point. From now on, comma, they want something, comma, they can well do it themselves, exclamation point. I'm taking up botanics, exclamation point. It looks like there is a gnome on strike here. Everyone keeps whining here. There's not even one gnome who understands my art, exclamation point. The balance of shapes, comma, the juxtaposition of colors, ellipsis. Nah, comma. They only know how to complain, comma, those yokels, exclamation point. It's the gnomish accent. If it's too annoying, I'll stop. Long ago, I decided that gnomes, verbalize their, crap, what's the word? Their notations? No. The question marks and commas and punctuation! There! That's the word I needed. Thank you, Omni. I do not think he is talking about me. It rather looks like he is mumbling something to himself. I cannot move on. This one with art, comma. That other with style, ellipsis. No one thinking about doing stuff as it should be, exclamation point. I won't lose time on trinkets when the structure is straw and paper, period. It wouldn't withstand a cricket's sneeze, exclamation point. This gnome does not look in the right mood for talking now. He looks quite nervous. Is there anything I can do here? Nope, I can't walk up the little ladder. Alright, let's move back. Maybe something's changed since we moved into here. Nope. It seems like it might be shameful to get a hint from the fairy so soon. Oh, maybe I missed this one? Oh, it's a great honor to host a real prince in our village! It's a great honor to host a real prince in our village! Unluckily, I am not in good spirits right now, period. I have to bear the ignorance of some bumpkins. Ellipsis. Never mind, period. I'll vent with my art! Talk to all of you now. Should go to the Spriggans! Pile some rocks, put a door, and they're happy! Ellipsis. Would be much easier, comma, it would! Oh, sure, you'll fit in just fine among troglodyte. Oh, comma, sure, comma. I almost slipped. You'll fit just fine among those troglodytes! You got the same artistic taste. Dash. Not at all, period. Sir, comma, do not lose time with him. Come, cotton, period. Come, comma, please, cotton, period. Okay, maybe I should stop because I'm tripping up on it now. I need to talk with you. Me and the carpenter think that you could help us. You should get the architect to understand how much you'd like to see our new library. Me? How could I change his mind? He's a big hardhead, a braggart and vain gnome. He'd surely be flattered by the interest of a foreign prince in his work. That will get him back to work for sure. You have to help us. So will you help us?
Yeah.
Fine by me. By now I am curious to see this library completed. Perfect. Thank you so much. We're counting on you. Be honest, this is all the painter's idea. Let's hope it works, or I'll end up carving briar root pipes for the rest of my career. Is this the architect, then? My subjects have just stopped working. It seems they can't get along well anymore. Did I miss one? No. I heard you are the architect of this pretty village. Oh, yes, I am. Of course it's me. I come from afar, looking forward to admiring the renowned architect of the gnomish folk. Excuse me. You come for nothing, then. The gnomish people just lost its greatest expert in the field. It is truly impossible to see the works of a master architect of your most excellent skill. I know there's a library in the works, the painter. The painter is the greatest expert in ignorance. His requests and the other gnome's demands make it impossible for me to work. How can anyone expect me to do anything up to my skill when I have to cater to the whims of the whole village? Well, to be honest, I would not know. That's it! No one knows because no one cares to imagine how it is to be in my shoes! I see. But you know, maybe you could find an agreement. Seeing you working would mean much to me, and... You want to see a sublime work? Want to witness the creation of this damn library? Well, do it yourself! Now you're the architect of this village, so even abroad they'll get what bumpkins of the gnome... Sorry. So even abroad they'll get what bumpkins the gnomes of this forest are. Huh? What? What a wonderful idea. A foreigner bringing his architectonic style to our village, buried by the eternal thorns. You've got my full endorsement, young prince. We'll be honored to host your flair. But I am a prince. I do not know how to construct a building. It's easy. Our architect just now threw you all his studies. You can use them as you like and discard the less useful ones less useful to your plans. If this can help ease your quarrels, I shall try, if the architect agrees. It does! Now you'll see what I was speaking about. It didn't go exactly as planned, but you look way more trustworthy and clever than that grouchy architect. You'll surely do a great job. Finally, the building will have a likable shape, will be cozy, and won't be full of frippery blocking my free-riding imagination. Yes, be careful. Give the wall the right importance, so that I can give the right importance to myself and my paintings. Okay. Well, this is frippery, so you just... Now you're the one directing the works. What are they thinking? What is your role in this endeavor? I'm the one who will have to keep your project standing. I cut boards, craft pillars, and work on the walls, too. I'm the village's carpenter. If you want to know what I think whenever you fancy the building should be, it'll need foundations raised from the ground. The village doesn't bear rain that well, and the books would get moldy very quickly. Apt foundations that get nourishment from water will keep the building steady and dry. Sketches I drew while trying to please everyone are on that table. Do whatever you want with them. As an expert in your trade, would you have some hint to give me? Hi, try to understand what these bumpkins want. Some can't even explain themselves clearly. If I were you, I would grill them mercilessly. I shall keep that in mind, thank you. Make sure you choose a roofing style. A roof fitting the style of the village. Help the gnomes with the blueprint. You can find the architect's sketches in the bottom part of the screen. Put them together and find the best combination according to what the gnomes want. Each of them wants something different, so try to make everyone happy with the results. Well, they said on the briars. Something about columns. Okay. So let's keep harassing them then. The building will be likable, but not flashy, and the walls will be there, waiting for me to enrich them with my art. I can barely wait. Have you started working yet? Already. Good, good. I have just one request for the library. It should have a bird's nest-proof chimney. There's a damned postman bird haunting my nightmares. Every time his girlfriend comes to visit, he makes their nest on my chimney, and I get smoked. I would like the new building to be spared from this fate. You know what I'd like, too? If I could look at the library and remember this spring, I feel it would bring us something special. You think you can fulfill this wish of mine? I shall see what I can do, village chief. You're a good lad, he says. I already looked at the mushrooms. They all have kind of rounded roofs, except for that one. Let's see what this guy has to say. Foundations are the key to a solid building. Raised and nourished, that's essential. Raised and nourished sounds like the briar. Is that it? Let's go talk to the bird, just in case. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's the mailman bird. I think it needs a mushroom roof, then. Let's try. needs a raised foundation. So that would work. Actually, any of these would work. And nourishing. So it should be a food. Carrots, then. Sure. Crow nest proof chimney? That looks about right. Simple but pretty walls. I mean, that's not simple though, that's simple. And then nobody said anything about that. Or the roof. Can I ask them more questions? You blend in with the undergrowth. Wait, new building will have to look like something natural that can blend in the undergrowth. During winters, animals come and look for our villages to find an easy meal. So avoid buildings shaped like steaks or ribs. It's better not to seem tasty. Okay. That's all you have to say. Remember the spring. Okay. Sure. This is weird. Nothing shaped like ribs. That seems springish, right? I mean, there's a little plant growing in, or flower. Let's go with the flower. I think that's a bird-proof chimney, but let's double check. Well, actually. No. Let's try it. From your face, I'd say your project is ready. Should I tell the other gnomes to wait? Natural looking, he says. That looks ugly. Just because I'm unsure. Foundations, raised and nourished. Likeable, but not flashy. He's not saying anything new. Okay. They all have the same sort of feel. Not ribs. That's all it is not ribs. Mimetizing? Okay, so... Didn't get anything about the walls, though. Why? I mean... Why not? Okay, let's try. It's gonna be wrong, but I don't care. Yes, we can begin. Not be said that gnomes are slackers when working. Fast and precise as always. Good job. Oh, wonderful. What smooth, airy walls. They're perfect. I like the design, I'll say. My plans already contain perfection in themselves. Looks like a good job. That chimney seems frightening enough to me. I dare the crow to build his nest there. Well, before judging, let's see how it is inside. How splendid! This library is just perfect for our village. I'm delighted. You did a great job, dear prince. This spring will be dedicated to celebrations. and we will be able to show off our new pride and joy. I am most glad you like it, but I simply use the studies of the architect gnome. The credit belongs to him, after all. I knew my work was fine, at least I'm satisfied. With the colors we'll concoct after the fairy festival, I'll fill it to the brim with masterpieces worthy of my name. How delightful. At last I'll have a place to catalog my essays on construction. Your modesty, Prince, suits your lineage. You have done an excellent job. Especially with that one decoration. It gives a touch of class to the whole. You've read my mind. It expresses exactly what I wanted. Spring-like and poetic. Yay! I'm a master architect.
No, I'm not!
I'd say we're going to celebrate this event. Bring forth the barrels, gnomes! I've attained the gnome's wish. Keep it with care. I had better leave the gnomes to their celebrations. What? Lo! That great mushroom is shining! You did it, Prince. You've brought serenity back to the gnomish folk. Doing so, you've proven your worth to the sorcery that oppresses the forest. Me? I have done nothing heroic, I believe. Of course you did. In exchange for your intervention, you have received the gnome's wish. What wish are you talking about? Now you will surely see it better. I followed you, or it followed you, leaving the village. And it is a symbol of the newly reforged peace the gnome folk... in the gnome folk. Your noble soul will break the spell over this forest. Oh no, now I can see it. I am not well versed in any magic art, though. How can I break the spell with a wish? No one can explain it to you, what you should exactly do. All we fairies know is that you have to be pure of heart. But no one knows what this really means. But we do know one thing, though. The mushroom is the seal holding back the energy of the forest from before the sorcery. Come forth and break the yoke that has been choking us. I hope you are right, and that I can live up to my duty.
He said duty.
Quick! Get by the mushroom, my dear prince. Now is the time. I'm already there. I should use the gnome's wish on this mushroom to activate it. Ooh, it's a puzzle. Hey, circles on this mushroom resemble miniature labyrinths. Okay, it's puzzle time. Would you like to read the tutorial?
Sure.
The wish is trying to reach the center of the labyrinth, but the road seems to be blocked. Help it find a path. Click and drag the circles to select and rotate them. When you think you have found a path, click the central circle to confirm. If you are stuck, you can ask for the wish's help. That's weird. Click on it to receive a hint about the path it would like to cover. First of all, it needs a way in, so... duh. That doesn't even line up. Alright, is there another entrance? Yes, there is. How about this one? Does that work? Eh. No. Why? Alright. Oh no, this goes this way anyway. There are three entrances! Let's try this one now. That doesn't line up. What? Yes, I know. but I have to line it up with the rest of the path. Oh, I see what you're trying to say. Alright, so I guess then I will solve it the way that I was going to in a moment. Which one of these actually lines up? That one. Okay. Wait, what? Oh, I see. It doesn't work either. Okay, so it needs a way in, which I have. Ah! I think I got it. Yay, I got it. That was very silly. Okay, I have to solve probably 4 more of them. 3 more, rather. Maybe. Or not. It is done! More wishes from things. The Thorms die if deprived of their vile energy. Keep going, Prince, and you shall save all of us. Now I have to go back to guarding the entrance to the forest. That's what I said, Hans. There's 3 more things. The Thorns die if deprived of their vile energy. Keep going, Prince, and you shall save all of us. Now I have to go back to guarding the entrance to the forest. You shall find me there at any moment if you are in need. Hopefully, but who knows? I mean, I don't know if this is one of those games that's supposed to get harder. We'll find out. I do not know what is waiting for me, but I know I can do it. Onward now. Is it going to be gnomes again? It's mermaids. And men. This place gives off a feeling of natural peace. The crystalline lake seems to be inhabited by mermen. That one's not a merman, though. Baleful nature, you lead us to ruin, even if we have always been so devoted to you. In just 1 year, the only legend will be left. Only legends will be left of us. The balance of this enchanted realm is already compromised. No one will be able to avert disaster. Yeah, probably. At the sunset of a 1,000-year society, old society, sorry, no one knows how to challenge this terrible fate. You've met with a terrible fate, haven't you? Oh, inauspicious destiny, a noble stock like us now declined by the desires of nature. A stranger is in our lake, and no one cares to look at him. Where did the merman's pride go? Poor me. Yes. It is a nice touch. I welcome you, Prince. Forgive the laments of my subjects. A calamity looms over us. It is not easy to find a solution. If only they didn't whine all the time, I could surely manage to think more clearly, and I could find a way to prevent our lake from drying up. What is the matter? What doom, you ask? It has been foretold that within the year the lake will dry up, slowly drained by that steam. We have tried to convince it to flow more slowly, but it has to follow its flow. It can't be helped. We mermen faithfully respect the course of nature. This does not mean that we want to die, though. However, my people have already lost all hope. If only we had been able to build strong and reliable works of engineering, we could have survived. I don't have ideas to offer to my people anymore. Can I go up there now? I probably could have from the beginning. This seems like a really good place for fishing. Fishing? There's fishing in this? Oh no! What else can I look at? Ooh. You found a... Yes, we did. You found a glowing flower. It shines like a star, but snugly fits under a mantle. Anything else? It seems to be it, just in case. Oh, an auspicious destiny. A noble stock like us and a client by the desires of nature. No one knows how to challenge a terrible fate. Are they really all just saying the same thing? In just 1 year, only legends will be left of us. Blah, blah, blah. Alright. Let's go talk to the gnomes. Doubt it, but maybe. Aha! Okay. Sir Architect, I come on behalf of the mermen. You met the fishies? Don't let anyone near their puddle. How did you do it? Or they don't. Those don't let anyone near their puddle. How did you do it? The mermen are in serious danger. Their lake is threatened by a new big drain, and your knowledge might help them. I see. That's pretty bad. As you are an alright guy, I'll tell the others to build a dam. The problem is, I don't really think the mermen will accept. First of all, you should convince them to let us near the lake. Go to Mermaid's Lake. I feel you need to relax a bit. Why don't you go to the lake for a while? Oh, I see. I should have talked to them already. Sir Carpenter, would you know how to build a dam? I am looking for someone willing to work for the mermen. Everything having a well-reasoned plan can be built, boy. What do you need a dam for? The merman lake will soon be drained by cause of a new brook that broke its equilibrium. The gnome's skill is needed to solve this predicament forthwith, lest it be too late to save them. You should ask the town's architect. It's his job. Let me warn you, though. You can't really reason with the mermen. I doubt they will accept our help. Yeah, whatever. Back we go to the lake. It probably did have a nose and mustache. I will check next time I'm there. For centuries, we protected this lake's purity. Nature is punishing us for not having it done well enough. Not having done it, rather. I would never accept this folly, having more foreigner come and dam us further. But the dam. The gnomes have offered to help us? Tell them I appreciate the thought, but accepting their help goes against our traditions. One can't avoid what's unavoidable. Is that really... Do you have anything else to say? No. Have you called in the gnomes? You were deceived then. They would never risk facing us mermen in battle just to save us. They are so what? They're so pragmatic. Letting the gnomes work on our lake? Preposterous! They would destroy everything without restraint. Never! Talk to the gnomes and they would help you. You talk to whom? Gnomes? No way! Only the mermen people can understand the will of the water, respecting its flow while taming its great power. Gnomes or any other people would just suffocate it. I appreciate your goodwill, but this is a job that only a merman could do. We are the only mermen in this forest, and none of us were able to convince the lake not to dry up. Maybe this truly is our unavoidable fate. Really? Can I use the fishing supplies to trap them? You found a shell. Since it's a lakeshore shell, you can actually hear the lake inside. Could you believe it? Can I go fishing? Could be used as a lantern, but I shall keep it with me for now. Okay. Wonder if they like listening to the sound of the lake. I don't think it's a rare relic for it. Let's put it back. Anything else here? No. Stupid merman. Wait. I wonder if there are other mermen outside this forest. This is such a vain hope, though. Can we dress the gnomes up like mermen? Let's see. That totally makes sense, right? First, let's check this thing. Yes, in fact, the stump or wood piece he's working on has a nose and mustache. And a beard, it looks like. Weird, I had a bad feeling about this merman thing. Bah! How'd it go? Alas, not well. They refuse our help. Of course they do. As I said, they will never accept any help from outsiders. We can't help you this time, Prince. Not me, at last. At least. However, if you tried asking the village chief for advice, he's got a brilliant mind when it comes to finding solutions to diplomatic matters. Guess that's why he is our chief. Yes, okay. Everyone's like, talk to the chief! And so the mermen don't want our help. I must say, I have expected this. Yes, yes, how foolish. Couldn't go otherwise. I've humiliated you, Prince. I shall admit, though, I had foreseen such an event. I had also thought of an alternative plan. Something quite clever and quite fun. Listen to me. Fish 3 big fish out of Merman's Lake and bring them to me. With them and a bit of diplomacy, we'll convince both the gnomes and the mermen to sort out this situation. Fishing, but I lack the means to do so, sir. Not a problem. The carpenter will solve that in a heartbeat. I'll obviously pay for it, so don't go wait further. Go ask him for a fishing pole. Okay. Sir Gnome, I would ask of you to craft a fishing pole for me. The village chief shall kindly cover the expenses if it is not a problem for you. Huh? What costs? I haven't seen a single coin since this spell was cast upon us. Ham and cheese are now the currency, and I surely won't take them from a traveler who needs them as provisions for his journey. We shall have your fishing pole in a heartbeat. Wait here. There you are. Well, good luck with your fishing, then. I can't see how this could help the mermen, but what you do in your free time is really not my business. Fishing rod. Yeah, I will let you know. I really like my art. I wonder if I'm the only one, though. Silly gnomes. 3 big fish. Wait, did it really say 3 big fish? Just in case. 3 big fish or it won't work. Let's go fishing. Time for a fish. Let's be efficient and get 3 of them quickly. I'm sorry. Are those gems I see beside you? You see well, Prince. I found them just now on the beach. Our lake is full of wonders, right? That's why us merfolk love it so much. Oh. It's probably an heirloom. They passed it down from his father, from his father's father, etc. You are indeed right. It is no small matter finding such natural wonders. And yet, I'll tell you, Prince, these gems would charm any merman if so I wished. But I would give them away if only someone would offer. What could bring you to seed such beauties? Does a quandary trouble you? Indeed, I'm following a strict diet, together with a fairy friend of mine, but I have to suspend it. I should eat nuts from the underwater realm, but my nutcracker broke. Crab pincers are not what they used to be. Were you to find one for me, I would even consider giving you these gems. Perchance, tell me, do they sell pincers in your realm? Because, you see, I cannot travel underwater to pick them. I would go myself, but I don't want to. I want to admire every second of my beloved lake before the end. If you would find those pincers for me, I'll give you the gems. Pretty please, Prince? It would be a favor. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to keep talking to them, just in case. How about you? How about you? Meow. Nope, I can't do that. Let's go fishing then. Seems like a really good place for fishery. Let's go fishing. Yes, how do I fish? Help the prince fish from the lake. To do so, you will have to reel them out of the water. Click and drag the cursor to move the captured area. By keeping the fish inside this area, the capture bar will fill. It's like, Stardew, except it looks kind of worse. On the other hand, if the fish manages to leave the area, it will start escaping. When the bar will have filled completely, you will have caught the fish. Yay. You fish suck just a bit. Haha! Is that a big fish? Small fish. Yes. That's a big fish. That is a big fish. No fishy fish. Why you gotta be like that? Come back. Stop it! I almost caught it too. That's a shame. Come on, fish. Do the thing. Stop it! Stop! I need that. Okay, cool. Oh, a pretty big thing just escaped. It left you something behind. You caught a shark's tooth. Yes. Okay. Well, this one's a lot more relaxed. And maybe a little annoying. Oh my gosh, hurry up. I need fish! Give me the fish, please. At least this isn't destroying my thumbs like Okami. A boot. I got a boot. It's like real life. No, stop running away from me, fish. Got it. It's not a fish. I caught a quagga. That might work as a pincer for what's-her-face. Stop! This fish sucks! Jeez! Come on. You should be getting tired by now, fish. Stop. We will probably lose this fish. That's no good. Darn it. This one is, like, weirdly frantic. Come on. Got it!
Ooh, a big fish!
Yes, I need 3 big fish. Is this the other big fish I need? Please be the other big fish I need. Because I need one more. Yay! Another big fish! Kind of makes me wonder what else I have to catch. Or can catch, even. Another one! We're gonna try this one more time to see what happens. At least one more time. Yeah, this one. I need this one. I wanna know what it is! Stop! Ugh! Yes. Clearly I have to, especially if it shows up again. And it didn't. This is a different fish. It's probably not even a fish. Oh, it is a fish. It's a tiny fish. Or small. Oh, it's this devil fish again. I will get you one day, you terrible little fish. I just need to keep it kind of on the thing. Come on. We can do this. Come on. You can get, no, you can eat it, it's fine. You just stick to my thing. Please. This is terrible. No. Come back. At least I'm kind of doing better-ish. Not really, though. Stop. I'm just whining now. I'm sorry. I guess I belong in the merman's domain. I thought I was doing better. Come on. Ah! Nothing is biting. Oh. Give me the terrible fish. There it is. First thing. Sweet. It's like the one fish. It's like, no, you cannot have me. I will. Someday. So freaking close, and then it just does the spaz thing, and I lose it. Ah. The fish. Give me the fish. Fish. Come on, fish, get in the boat. Fish, come on, get in the boat. Fish. or on the beach, as the case may be. Demon fish, stop! I guess I'm just not allowed to. Maybe I should give up on it. So close, and then I lose it all. I want to catch fish, but not this fish. Yeah, I'm just gonna... You take the pincers. Here you are, the pincers for you. How wonderful, you truly are a gentleman prince. Here, accept these gems in return, as promised. Your help has been way more valuable. Gems! You've obtained gems. They are the most precious reward after honor, of course. Have something else to say? How about you? Nope. Alright, to the gnomes! Big fish. Okay. But I caught three big fish. Oh, here we go. This will do. Two left. This fish is perfect for what I have in mind. Still, one more left. These fish are perfect. Now on with the second part of the plan. I'll need some decorations to flaunt, too. Some that would satisfy the merman. What kind of decorations? Mermen are a proud folk. When two clans meet, they flaunt items that symbolize the qualities of their clan. Usually, they show a symbol of strength and one that proves the beauty of their waters. I'll need two items that suit those goals. Gems? I have found something that could suit just right. Good, good. Give them to me. Something that could suit just right. Good, good, give it to me. Good, I fear we're forgetting something, but it's like I forgot something that no merman would miss in its uniform. Something made of wood with tips, maybe. Oh, my age bites me. Anyway, tell my gnomes that they have to disguise as mermen now. We'll be happy to help you. It's wood. I'm gonna actually go back and try to catch that one fish again. Just in case. Eh. Sure. Okay, it's just minimized. I thought the game crashed. Why did that happen again? Oh, no, no, no. This is the wrong spot. That. What am I doing? I've screwed this up. That looks like part of his hat, so that goes there. Switch. There we go. Exploring other places. I really feel like maybe I need to catch that fish or it's going to eat the gnomes. this devil fish immediately. Really? Okay, cool. Come on, come on, come on. I've lost almost all the bar now because this thing sucks. Oh well. I give up. Again. Alright, time to talk to the gnomes. To approach them without provoking them, you'll need to disguise as a merman. The chief has a fish you can wear. What? No, no, wait, what? This is the I keep trying to say chef. The chief's idea. The mermen only accept other mermen into their lakes. This seems to be our only option. What the hell? Language. Ugh, okay. A dam for a crystalline lake. I have to decorate it with my art so that it better fits the landscape. This is something I have never done before. I can't wait to start. The village chief exhorts you to wear this. I hope it will not dampen your enthusiasm. I have to wear a fish. Oh. Why? Oh, wait, I see. We will disguise as mermen so that they leave us working to the lake. Wonderful. It's fascinating. Amusing. Let's do it. So no. Village chief wants you to wear this. I should wear a fish costume? What the hell does it mean? First they ask me to build a dam, then to be a stinky fish like them? Let's hurry. Go to the fishies before I change my mind. Change the items. Okay, hold on. I think maybe we should give them this shell. And the shark tooth. Just in case. Let's... Oh, it's again. Your pardon. Do you perchance need this saw? Huh? No. I don't need it right now. Do you? Take it, take it. I still have to keep working on this log for a fair while. Thank you. I will give it back as soon as possible. Okay. Yes, perfect. Here is the new costume. Ugh, thanks. Here is the new disguise. Yeah, you know, I just delighted. Let's get a move on. Here is the new disguise we have chosen. Oh, here's my new stage costume. I could jump clear out of my fins. Is this here before? Mirror. It seems that nobody is using it right now. I think I will borrow it. It might be useful later on. Do you think you look royal enough today? Really? Alright. it's out of place, and like we can pick it up. No. All right, let's see. Here we are, Prince. Let us hope our presence won't enrage them. Look, my subjects, mermen! Mermen at the doors of our lake. Such a surprise! What, mermen? But... wait. Those are imposters. They have nothing like the true pride of mermen. Bess. What? And their ambassador doesn't even have a trident. I see why they flaunt with such pride those common shells. Many better nerds. Oh, all right. Fools, they are gnomes disguised as mermen. Ignorant gnomes laughing at us while we lay in our great misfortune. I screwed up. Oh well. This isn't working as planned. We'll bend from this lake. Whoever tries to approach, disappear before I decide to impose a death penalty on foreigners. Go away. I'm a gnome now. Do I have to? Really? I am Prince Philip, and and I shall save Aurora. I have lost track of the last prince, finding only his items. Take them, you will need them for his quest. It does make a bit more sense, but now I'm sad. It's a lame hat now. You'll find me guarding the forest if you need help. Good luck, Prince. Thank you. I will do my best. Alright, do I have all of his items. I can have one last joy. Oh, it's right back to where I was, but with a different prince. Okay. Harsh! Let me pick that up before. Red rose, so fresh and delicate. Is there anything else I failed to pick up? Refined clothes. It looks like he wants to stay away from the others, best leaving him in peace. His little gnome hat is kind of cute, though. Alright, let's, I guess, maybe try to catch that dumb fish? Okay. Sure. Make a trident. Oh, because it looks like a trident. Ugh, can't believe I missed that. You've obtained a branch. Guess what? It's made of plain wood. Here, I should bring it all to the carpenter. Here is as you saw. Do you think you could craft a trident out of this branch? Ah, thought you would bring in some wood for the fire. Oh, well, if you need a trident, I'll do it now. Really perfect. If I am not asking too much. No worries. Here is nothing.
It almost does, yeah.
You have obtained a trident. You needed a tip. Now you have three.
Trident, shark tooth, and let's try the gems.
One symbol of strength, one symbol of wealth. That's what we missed. Excellent, Prince. We will use this as ambassador flag. Decorate as needed. Yes, it's a custom of theirs. That's what I was forgetting. I found something that could suit just right. Good, give it to me. Very well. We will decorate the trident with the gems you gave me. Tell my gnomes that we will have to disguise as mermen now. We'll be happy to help you. To approach them without provoking them, you will need to disguise as a merman. The chief has a fish you can wear. This is the chief's idea. Mermen only accept other mermen under their lake. Blah, blah, blah. Wear this. Fish costume. Okay. Fish costume. Everything is ready. Let's go become a gnome again. Here we are, Prince. Let's hope our presence won't enrage them. Look, oh subjects of mine. Mermen. Mermen to the gates of our lake. Such a surprise. Is this your handiwork, Prince? What does this mean? Have they come to help us? Oh, here I introduce you, the river mermen. The river Zoras. They hail from outside the forest, and they received your cry for help. It is the case that they are great connoisseurs of the engineering arts, and they would help you. Only true mermen would display such relics upon their trident. They really must be a proud and respectable tribe. Then we won't have to perish this year. Mother Nature does not desire this. We can be helped. I don't know. This is a blessing. Welcome, wise river merman, builders respectful of nature. Please save our people. Excuse our skepticism, Prince. We would never have imagined that there were other mermen near our lake. Tis all right. No problem. So that's the rivulet which takes your life away. Start an architecture lesson then. There's no time to waste.
And I hate the stink.
Oh, you speak like a true worker, my friend. But yes, there isn't much time left. Sweet. There may be a pile of failed princes at the end. That was very instructive. The river mermen have explained to us their plan for the dam, which shouldn't undermine the balance of the lake at all. Without your intervention, this wouldn't have been possible. We are very grateful, Prince. Soon the construction will start. Let us clean this lake. My subjects get sorted. Yes, sir. Yay, we got the wish. Seems like the mushroom is reacting again. I had better check it out. Yay! Another puzzle.
Alright. That one. Unless there's... Oh, wait. Yeah, that's the only one that goes into that.
Seems wrong. I think I need an extra long one? Like... No. Nah, it's not that much more complex. It's just different.
to think about it. There, maybe. We have a long path with that one. And do we have a path with two branches out? Goes the wrong way. Huh, okay. All right, so then maybe that isn't the answer with the blue. Is there another one? Down this way, that doesn't work. This isn't going to work. Yep, okay. So, rotating it in that direction is not going to work. How about that? Doesn't line up at all! Where does that? I feel like there's only one path that actually lines up appropriately. Which isn't this one. Imagine that. Okay. There's this one that does three directions. Does that work? No. Why would I think that would work? So we have three spaces we can use. That makes us go backwards, which doesn't work in any other part. See you later, Omni. Have a great night and a great weekend. This one lines up. That helps slightly.
ish. So it can come together here. That's not gonna help. That'll go the wrong way, except for that. That one goes sort of the right way. It seems like it's gonna be a little bit more complicated, like by a lot. That's weird. So I'm wondering now if I'm thinking in the wrong direction. So it's the only way that can go. How many of these actually line up? That one does. Doesn't match up at all. Straight. Oh, that's the same one. Startlingly more difficult, I think. I mean, I'm usually pretty good about puzzles, but having to make the path with the pieces is not always the easiest. Alright, how many of these? This one has a thing like that, but that doesn't go in anywhere. There's two pieces in this that match up. Dumb. All right. Well, that matches, but that doesn't go anywhere. That's all right. Don't worry about it. I'll get it eventually. I just need to sort it out a little bit better. Oh, I didn't know that it did that. That's cheating. Pattern. And there's only one way that can go. Ugh, this is dumb. So it has to go at a weird angle like this. No, that's wrong, I think. See, I wouldn't have as much of a problem with it if it wasn't spinning. It's the spinning that throws me off. Which is weird, because I'm actually pretty good at spatial visualization, but this is weird. Why did I move it?
make it. Just put this back to the way it works. So what lines up over here? That one. Kind of. Straight through ones aren't going to help. Works. Follow this path then. I can go that way. That doesn't work for anything. Nope. Nope. Back here. How long will it be before this music drives me crazy? That doesn't work either. I think it really does have to be this one. Yeah, it... This path is the most open, but... Seven paths that the green one can do that makes it so at least the little wispy dude can go through. At least go down one. I pumped into my thing and then my pop screen attacked. Stop it. There. Still only has three, but it's... catch up with anything either. Alright, yeah, that's true. So yeah, there's five that work. We just go straight through. It's the blue ring that's throwing me off right now, because I'm pretty sure that's where the yellow one needs to go. Closes off all the weird paths the stupid thing could take. Which is probably wrong, but... particular plug. Stop. Nope. 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 Why would that work? It doesn't. All right, back to the way it was. I don't want to cheat, but I'm taking way too long in this dumb puzzle. That's a dead end. That doesn't do anything for me. Is there a blue one that goes down twice? No. All the blues go in one. Well, that doesn't count. I mean, I guess it's possible that that one is wrong, but that doesn't make sense either. Sorry, I'm grumbly. That's not right either. right this way? That doesn't match up with anything. At least not anything useful. I mean, even that one. There are a couple that kind of line up here. No, I need it to be like this. That's a... I think I just accidentally solved it. Let's go. I don't remember if I click on that. That's it. Wait. Why is it... No, click on the middle thing. Whatever, I did it. Yay! That was dumb. I'm sorry. I'm the worst today. I hope it doesn't add two more layers of terrible to this for the next two. Ew. Let's see what's in the next area. Oh no, the fairies. The fairy circle, incredible. Is it just like I imagined them back in my childhood? Will I get attached? Or will I get to attend one of their dances, I wonder? Do you like this? Yeah, the in and out 8 times is irritating, because, like, I can do it. It just takes me forever sometimes. Especially when you have to spin the pieces. Don't you like this? It looks as if it was made especially for you. Ridiculous! It makes me look like a tacky bum... Bonbonnier? Oh, do you think so? Yeah, what do you want, human? Don't you see we're at a critical moment? No, do not be like this. You are the first dancer. That color underlines your silver eyes. Huh? Oh, and who might you be? We are very busy. The Spring Festival is just behind the corner. Well, I thought that, yes, you should try. Well, yes, I do understand your tastes. No, it's all wrong. I'm so sorry, dancer. Oh, a prince is coming to our village. Welcome to our fairy ring. We are all very busy getting ready for the Spring Festival now. We are currently working on the dress for the first dancer. It is so hard to cater the It is so hard to cater to the first dancer's tastes. But she's right. Her appearance is essential for a successful festival. What? Should I really wear something this rough? No! You have no taste. How dare you call yourselves yourselves stylists? My dress needs a detail. As bright as the pale moonlight, piercing through the treetops in a fresh March morning. We don't have anything like that in our village. Find it somewhere else, then. Please be reasonable. How about no? I'd better not. No, I don't think this is useful. Excellent! Yes, now we're getting closer, but this... I obviously can't show myself at a ball. Springtime dress must contain something bright and shiny as the reflection on a drop of morning dew at the break of dawn. Well, that's not it. Ooh. Sure, the mirror. No, this will not do. Okay. Okay, I should probably stop just aimlessly guessing. Oh, it helps, doesn't it? Maybe I should go talk to the merman. That makes sense. Maybe. Dear Prince, I thank you again for the help you gave us. If it wasn't for you, we would have been doomed. You want something shiny for the fairy's first dancer? Well, what's better than the pristine waters of our wonderful lake? I hope I have been of help. No, you haven't. Incredible! I would have never expected help from the river, Merman. I didn't even know there was a river inhabited by mermen outside of the forest. What great news! Mayhaps one young lady like you could help me. I'm looking for a shiny and luminous ornament for the first dancer's dress. For the first dancer, you mean? I would have an idea, but it doesn't look feasible. The golden scales of the Merman King are the most brilliant and majestic object one could find in our kingdom. The problem is, he's very jealous of them, so I don't think he will part with even one. Thank you, Prince. Your Majesty, I really have need of one of your scales. Forgive my weird question. Do you happen to have a spare one? A scale of mine. Even if you helped us, I can't give it to you. It represents the greatest pride of my tribe. Only the rightful merman monarchs have the right to hold these golden scales. Dang it. I thought it would be easy. Not really, but still. Do you have something else to say? As expected, His Majesty has refused. I can't help you, Prince. Don't give up, though. Try asking other mermen. Okay. No. So the king doesn't want to give you a golden scale. Well, it had to be expected. In the name of the help you gave us, I want to offer you a chance to get it. Bring me a dark berry, and I'll help. Try to help you. A dark berry, they say. I have a dark berry yet. New. No. Can you help me? No, I should probably talk to the fairies first. But maybe the gnomes know what I should do. My informers told me that the river merman explained to our dear merman how to build a dam. It'll be fun to see my gnomes direct in the construction, armed with tails and trident. Construction. Working on a new project. Art on the dam. Always working. Okay. Ooh, let's talk to the prince. Or at least try to. Okay. Nope, that doesn't work. Alright, back to the fairies. But gold and silver? Ew. It's a bad combination. It's not the worst, but... Do they just happen to have one laying around here? Lying around. No. Okay, it's difficult. No. Nope. I can't dress myself like this at the ball. The springtime dress must contain something as bright and shiny as a Yes, no good. Alright, it's 5, so I need to call it here. Thank you very much for joining me today. I hope you have a great night and a great weekend, and I will see you all on Wednesday. Later, everybody. Or not Wednesday. Wow, Monday. I am so just wrong today. Alright, later.